Hello and welcome to this Cursed City painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint a couple of the mysterious objects that you'll find inside the Cursed City box set. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is a nice starting point for all the varied tones we're going to be using. Now, the first thing we're going to pick is going to be the crow on top of the pillar. And we'll be using Administratum Grey as kind of a pre-highlight before we start applying some contrast to it. So what I'm going to do is get myself a small dry brush. I'm just going to get a little bit of Administratum Grey onto my bristles, and then all I'm going to do is do circular motions and then crisscross it. What we're aiming to do here is remove as much of the pigment from the bristles as possible, but without removing too much paint, so we can still get some definition. So once I'm happy with that, all I'm now going to do is then start gently flicking back and forth on the stonework as well as the crow. Like I said, this can give us a bit of a pre-highlight. There we are with that dry brush now done. What we're now going to do is apply the rest of the colours to this mysterious object. First of all, we're going to use Griff Charger Grey, which we're going to apply all over the stonework of the pillar. Then we're going to use Black Templar for the crow. Then we're going to pick out the key using Iron Hand Steel. And finally, for the roots and the key to make it look a bit aged, we'll coat that in Skeleton Horde. But first of all, let's start off with Griff Charger Grey. So what I'm going to do here is just apply a little bit of Griff Charger Grey to the palette. This is not to thin it down, it's just so I can get a decent point. And also not to overload the brush too much. And then all I'm going to do is then just start coating that over the stonework. It's going to give it a bit more of an eerie kind of stone, because on some of the packaging, they have like a bit of a bluey kind of greeny hue to it. So Griff Charger Grey is perfect for that. There we are, the pillar done. What we're now going to do is just pick out the crow by using Black Templar. Coating over the entire crow, like so. There we are, with the crow now picked out, we're going to pick out the key using Iron Hand Steel. There we are, the key base coated. What we're now going to do is apply Skeleton Horde over to the key to make it feel like an aged old key, and also onto the roots as well, just to give them a bit of colour. And there we are, with the Skeleton Horde now dry, our crow on the pillar mysterious object is now done. So what I'm going to do now is move on to our next one, which is the Hangman's Noose. Now for this, we're going to start off with a dry brush over the whole thing using Morgas Bone. Then we're going to pick out any metal bits using Iron Hand Steel. Then we're going to coat over the whole thing using Skeleton Horde. Then for the wood itself and the hood, we'll be using Saigor Brown. And then we're just going to highlight the skeleton up using a little bit of Pallid Witch Flesh, which we'll dry brush as well. But first of all, let's start with Morgas Bone. So again, another dry brush. So all we're aiming to do here is remove as much from the bristles as possible, crisscrossing like so, and then just double check to make sure most of that's gone, which it has. And then all I'm going to do is then just start heavily flicking that back and forth over the skeleton. Like I said, I'm going to do it over the wood as well, because that'll actually give some detail when we start applying those washes later on. There we are, with that dry brush now done, what we're now going to do is use Iron Hand Steel to pick out some of the nails that have been hammered into the gallows. With those nails picked out, what we're now going to do is get Skeleton Horde and just apply that all over the skeleton, the gallows, the rope, and of course the little leaflet that's just been nailed on there as well. There we are, the Skeleton Horde now dry. We're going to use Saigor Brown, which we're going to apply to the hood and the wood of the gallows. There we are, the Saigor Brown now dry. All we're going to do now is highlight that skeleton up using a bit of Pallid Witch Flesh. So I'm just going to gently dry brush that over just to pick out those raised areas. And there we are, with the dry brush now done, our mysterious objects are now completed. And remember, just by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply the stone effect and bone effect to other models within the set. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own mysterious objects. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.